Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna. I am so pleased today to be joined by Matt Markham. Matt, it's great to have you here again.
Thanks, Dr. McKenna. Good to be here.
Obviously, Matt's been with us before, and it's always great when he's here. We're going to give you the update from Albany Med Health System today, and today is Friday, June 17th. No COVID talk today. We're going to talk about something different. It's a very special week here at Albany Med Health System, and we had a very special launch of a campaign, and we wanted to talk about that. You can see I'm wearing my Albany Med Health System t-shirt. I think many people out there, Matt, are probably wearing theirs as well. On Fridays, a lot of people are wearing them. This is the week where we launched the internal campaign for the Albany Med brand.
Yes.
And let's talk about that, because I think that's important. The first question is, why did we do this, right? Why did we decide to go ahead with that? Well, first of all, we're very unique in this region, right? Mm-hmm. We are the only regionally governed, locally controlled health system. Mm-hmm. And we recognize that as part of this health system, there's identity and there's brand recognition and there's value in having a singular logo and brand. So talk a little bit more about that.
Well, it even goes back to 2016 when the first what we called affiliates at that point, Columbia Memorial Health, had joined a new kind of partnership for the Capital Region. And as we went through the years, Saratoga Hospital then joined, Glens Falls Hospital joined, and then the visiting nurses came on board fairly recently. So what we have formed here in the Capital Region is very similar to what we see in other regions throughout the United States, where hospitals and even home care agencies partner together to strengthen themselves as part of a network. And in many cases, they take on a singular identity so that the public clearly knows these are organizations that are working together for the benefit of the communities in which they live and serve. The local governance piece, I think, is really unique about us.
Absolutely.
Too, in the sense that we have 16,000 colleagues, 16,000 t-shirts going around.
Excellent.
That we had, you know.
One for everybody.
Yep, and big boxes coming through our offices. But I think the really special thing about that is that each of those 16,000 colleagues had a direct role in formation of this system and will have a direct role in its continuing history too. So when you look at our brand, again, behind us, you see what we call the Action A. We teased this a couple of weeks ago, but if you see the three lines in the A, it's patient care, research, and education, which is now our singular system mission. And over the course of this week, we've had a lot of materials go out that really kind of explain more of the meaning. You know, it's not necessarily an A in a circle and colors and logo changes. It's research in the communities that suggested that a partnership with Albany Med was admirable and respected and something that the community was looking forward to as a way to sustain what we have all spent more than 100 years working to sustain. The fact that we are now sharing specialists across our hospitals, and the fact that, again, back to the historical component of this, each hospital's been in their community since about 1900, in some cases earlier. Yeah. The medical college is 1839, and all of that together, the research component, makes a very strong and vibrant system that we all have a role in perpetuating and serving it.
No question about it. On the back of this t-shirt is this incredible map, and I think you'll see it on various display screens in the hospital, or you'll see it in elevators, and there's a little pin where each of the hospitals resides and in the year in which they were founded. I mean, these are all hospitals within our health system that have a very strong connection to their local communities, very proudly so. And none of this is meant to disrupt that. In fact, if anything, I think this bolsters that. And this says to those communities, you know, you should be very proud that you have a hospital in your community meeting your needs, and that hospital is part of a broader system. You know, it's interesting, Matt, you know, people like you and I, we spend much of our day working on system issues. But to people on our front lines, people who might work in our CAT scan or in our outpatient practice location or in our facilities, they may not necessarily even understand on this campus the totality of the system. Mm. So some of this is an education for our workforce. You mentioned the Action A and the tripartite mission of clinical care, education, research. In point of fact, I could point to examples throughout the system today where there's partnerships going on in each of those areas, where residency programs, for example, people who traditionally do training after medical school are doing that at Saratoga Hospital with collaboration with Albany Medical Center. where clinical care clearly is being done at a system level, various areas like pathology or neurosurgery, where we are the sole provider of those services throughout the system, and many other examples coming on. And research, there's research that's occurring across the system where data is being collected and research is occurring, not just here on the other campuses. So this is as much about educating our workforce as what's happening. And then obviously, if we know that there's opportunities to educate our own workforce, we know also there's an opportunity to educate the public. Mm-hmm. And the question is why? Because as we're spending our time building a singular electronic medical record across the system, which we think will be the neural network for the system, which will pull together all of the clinical data so no matter where anybody goes in our system, it's visible to the care providers. We want the community to understand that. And they know that the care promise and delivery at Glens Falls is the same as it is down in Columbia and everywhere in between. I think it's very exciting.
And it's really, I think, the thread that pulls the system together, too, in the sense that when we tell the community that we are going to elevate and maintain one level of quality care from Hague to Hudson, the electronic medical record and the ERP, the Enterprise Resource Planning Process, as well, helps us redouble our commitment to that promise.
So let's talk about the story. For people who walk down the hall and they grab a copy of the story, and typically the focus is on this campus, is that correct?
Yes, and what we have done with the, we're calling it the system story.
I was going to get to that, but go ahead and take that.
Yep, so this week we had a lot of materials go out to the point of trying to educate the workforce. We know that our colleagues are our greatest advocates in the communities in which they live. So we want to start first by letting everybody know why this change is happening. We talked about that in a letter from you and the other CEOs on the campuses. All campus boards, the system boards, and the system board, singular board, and the CEOs all endorse what we have done in bringing the Albany Med Health System identity out into the community. So it started with that. Also, a beautiful video that was produced by John Duchesi, Rob Sager, Dave Gardner, and the communications department is also running in various places across the system.
It's a great video.
Yeah,
it's really a great video.
And it's wonderful to see everybody from the various campuses and scenes from the various campuses, everybody doing what they love to do.
Absolutely.
The story, meanwhile, went out yesterday in digital format across the campuses. And again, it talks about the meaning behind the brand. It has some stories about employees who now work in integrated functions, so employees who may sit in Hudson or Saratoga or Glens Falls and perform and execute responsibilities that have an effect on all the campuses within the system. We talk about the Care One EMR ERP initiative, and we do talk about Dr. Shin and her team in pathology, cardiology services that are integrated across the system, and even things like payer contracting, the fact that as a group, we can leverage greater benefits for our system and for the patients that we serve. And then I suppose this video is the end of a week that not only did we want to educate our workforce of 16,000, but we hoped at the beginning of this week that not only would you start to understand the change in many cases, but be proud of the change and feel a really deep connection to who we are as the Albany Med Health System. So I sincerely hope that we achieve that, and there's only more to come from here.
I am certain you achieved it, and I want to thank you and your team and the teams on all four campuses and the Visiting Nurses Association who worked together to put this. The story, the system story, is great. I loved reading it because it was an opportunity to see what's happening on all the different campuses and the interconnection that occurs across the entire workforce. And when you talk about the 16,000, we're talking about our workforce now, and we're talking about the system workforce and that number there. And that's how increasingly we're going to talk about the system going forward as one entity working together. Local identity, local culture, local medical staffs, connected to their communities in ways that are very important, but part of a broader system working together to advance healthcare in the region.
And to the folks in the communications department, we are one of those integrated departments now across the system. And to the folks here in Albany and at Columbia Memorial Health in Saratoga and Glens Falls and the visiting nurses, everybody did Herculean work over the last couple of weeks to make sure that everything was in just the right place with just the right tone. You know, sometimes it's not so much what you say, but how you say it that really brings people along. And we certainly are very proud to share this story with you and hope that you come along with us, because this is really just the beginning.
Right. And we all, I guess I'd end on this note too. We also hope that you would share it with your friends and family.
Absolutely.
You know, tell them proudly that you work as part of the Albany Med Health System, wherever it is you work, in any of our four campuses, in any of our more than 100 offsite locations. And obviously, if you're watching this video, it's probably easy to forward it to someone, share it with someone. And hopefully in the future, if you don't already, you'll have the t-shirt.
Absolutely.
And I wear mine every Friday.
Yes, they're starting to arrive on the campuses just this week. So wear them at work, wear them outside, wear them proudly.
Absolutely. All right. I can't think we can say better than that, Matt. Thank you to you and your team.
Thank you.
Work. And thank you to everybody who made that happen. That's it. We're rolling into the weekend. I think it's Father's Day weekend, so we wish all the fathers out there certainly a happy Father's Day weekend. And we'll be back again next week.
Have a great weekend. Right. Happy Father's Day to you and to mine.
Absolutely, for sure. We ask that you once again please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and we'll see you next week.